Having said that, let's move to the third topic. That is, what are the various types of advertising media which is available? They can broadly be classified into four heads. First being indoor, second being outdoor, also popularly known as mural, third being direct, and fourth being promotional. Well, indoor advertising includes the press media, the radio, the television, or the films. These are the advertisements which happen indoor or within the households of the customers. Whereas the second form is the outdoor or the mural, which basically includes the posters, the advertising billboards or the hoardings, or the traveling display, which we generally see on trams or buses or in autos or in metros. And finally, the sky advertisements. Under direct advertising media, they are generally including the sales letters, the booklets in the catalogs, the folders, the package inserts, the store publications, etc. The whole idea of direct media is to reach out to the customers directly and not to a target audience. And the next one is the promotional advertising media, which basically includes the window display, the interior display, showrooms, exhibitions, etc. Having said that, let's understand what is an advertising copy. It is the reading matter, the words, the sentences, the paragraphs, subheads, headings, and figures in an advertisement. A good advertising copy should basically have the AIDA or the AIDA formula, which stands for A for attention, I for interest, D for desire, and A for action. Having said that, what we really mean to say here is an advertisement copy should be capable enough of first drawing the attention of the targeted audience or capturing the attention of the targeted audience. Because only when we capture the attention of the targeted audience can the next of the steps follow and finally lead to a purchase. After having caught the attention of the consumers or the targeted consumers, the second step is to create an interest in them. That is, to retain the interest with them with our product and our particular service industry. That is, to create the advertising copy in such a nice, interesting, and appealing way that the customers are forced on to actually stick on to understanding the whole of advertisement. The next step being the desire stage. That is, our advertising copy should create a desire within the customer to actually own the product or to own the service. And finally, it should be followed by an action. That is, the rest of the steps will make no sense if it does not lead to finally the action, that is the purchase action. The advertisement copy should finally lead to the purchase being done on the behalf of customer. Having said that, let's understand how to create a successful advertising copy. Well, the first important stage in that is to define the goal of your message. That is, what is it that we want to do? Do we want to attract our customer? Or do we want to interest them? Or do we want to create a desire to own our product? Or do we want them to get into an action of purchasing the particular product? Having defined the goal is the first step for creating any successful advertisement copy. The second being knowing your audience and what do they want. That is, who do you want to reach out to? Is your customer the urban customer or is it the rural customer? Or it is the customers who are located in the B and the C grade cities. Until and unless you know your audience, it is no point creating your advertisement copy, because choosing your media depends completely on the targeted audience we want to reach out to. Third is, appeal to their self-interest and not yours. We are talking, or the advertisement is meant to talk to the customers. Hence, we need to reach out and appeal to what interests the customers and not what is of interest to us. Next being, make an emotional appeal and not a logical one. Most of the purchases which happen on a regular basis for the convenience goods and the shopping goods happen on more of an emotional basis rather than a logical one. Hence, having an emotional aspect or an emotional turn to your advertisement will always turn out to be way more effective than a one which is very factual and logical. The next being, do not give them any choices. In the sense, one advertisement should reach out for only one particular product. Do not confuse your customers with 10 different products in one advertisement, because that will neither be able to catch their attention, nor get their interest, nor get them a desire. All we will end up doing is confusing the customers and losing their interest and them finally. Next being, make your best offer. Since the advertisement has such a mass reach and we are reaching out to our targeted customers, it is very important to make your best forward offer in the first go itself. That is, if any discounts or offers or any other promotional techniques which we want to reach out to, it is very important to speak about it in the advertisement itself. And finally, simplify everything. Well, as they say, it's more difficult to simplify things and it's easier to complicate. Keep your advertisement simple and reaching out to your target audience directly so that they understand it and do not get lost in the entire advertisement thing.